know the guys are
sitting. We've seen the whirl away and the duels
too fast.
Get put up. Come back. The competition in the sky.
an old one.
Now, Ben Cartwright, you've had time flying the Hawk 127.
What?
Chris Shamil is setting up now for his display. It's a great little aircraft. Very good. The HUD, as I said before, down the front. Able to go low flying. 400 knots, just 250 feet above the ground. Now the inverted pass. The eagle should be hanging upside down. It's 5 straight across. That's the thing. You're in the sequence. Pulling G sideways, up, down, left and right. This aircraft can actually put more G than the Hornet. So when they go up and they go into exercises like pitch black, and the like, if they don't get seen, because they're quite nibbly, they like to stay low, and if they get to jump on the Hornets, they can actually turn inside them and get their nose straight around in attempts to put the missile on the target of their big brothers.
Oh, here it comes.
I think of a few Hornet pilots that might have their noses slightly out of joint about that. That's the information that Chris has provided me with. He loves flying this aircraft, such as the capability. Any of the boys and girls in the crowd that think they've got the right stuff, as it were, to become a future fighter pilot, within about 18 months to 2 years, they could potentially be flying a Hawk at number 79 spot. The typical training progression is going to officers' training school over at RAAF Base New Sale for 17 weeks, then jumping on board the CT-4, the Parrot, up at Tamworth, getting 60 hours there,